Give you a ride. She's like, yeah, I need to go and cash this check. I said, yo, you give me, it's quid pro quo if I give you a ride. You know what I mean? She's like, what do you mean? I said, that's Latin for something, you want a ride? You know what I mean? It's always something for something. You want, you buy me lunch, I'll take you where you need to go. So it was that kind of thing. And so, you know, I give a ride to the joint to cash a check, man. End up smashing the check. Right in back of the Beamer. Right in back of the Beamer. Yeah. because it was that, never give her the attention, huh? Because too many dudes was on it. And the dude, the head dude of the company, man, when he would talk to her, he would get mad nervous. So, and you would think that this guy was an alpha. I'm saying that to say what she said. Like, the dudes, he had the dudes in check, but a woman would come around and the dude would just melt. Like, yeah. Break down. That's a fake alpha. That's not a real alpha. Because that means he gave the woman power over him. You understand what I'm saying? And that causes a woman to lose attraction. And that's what she told me. She was like, I said, yo, how come you don't talk to none? She's like, because they all get freaking nervous when they start talking to me. They get so damn nervous. And, you know, I don't, that's a turnoff. So, yeah, I could dig it. Yeah. That's how it is, man. Now, every dude that try to come across as an alpha is not really an alpha.
Come on. That's that attention too, like you were saying, when a dude give a woman all the attention, you know, she becomes, you know, accustomed to it, get used to it, and then she don't want it. Yeah. But that attention that she can't get, like, you ain't paying her no mind, she trying to get in your vision then.
Especially the more attractive she is, because she's used to that. Like, she can't, that's the blow of death right there, huh? Mm-hmm. That's the blow of death. She used to do, check, man, get out of here. Wow. Can't fake it, huh? Can't fake it. Gotta keep it all the way real, man.
Yeah.
Romy, I'm shocked that you didn't come on here. Anybody else got any more questions for Sierra? So Sierra, so I mean, it seems like you're on a seesaw with who's the prize. The man's the prize, the woman's the prize. The man's the prize, the woman's the prize. What is your conclusion on that?
My conclusion is, like, I thought.
From you, what do you really believe in your heart? What do you really believe
in? The man is
prize. But why? Why do you say that? Why? What makes the man the prize? All right, what about the guy that I told you about a little earlier? The guy, he's making $22,000 a year. He got two children. How is he the prize?
He's not the prize.
Okay, you just said the man's the prize.
Unless he, you said what?
You just said the man's the prize.
Yeah. The man is the prize if he has worked himself up to be the prize.
Okay, so just like now a man working money, what makes him the prize then? How does he work himself up to being a prize?
Healing, I mean, going to therapy, healing himself, becoming his best self physically, mentally, spiritually.
What? Why does he need to go to therapy unless something's wrong with him?
Well, a lot of men have trauma and they don't talk about it. So can he manage his emotions? Has, you know, he built himself up to where he's ready to be in a relationship? I mean, other than finance, it's like, has he mastered his craft or found who he is? And is he satisfied with that? Or is he struggling mentally because, and emotionally, is he angry because he hasn't reached his fullest potential and doesn't know himself? I think there's levels to a man becoming the prize within his own ideology. And like you said, when people see you're confident, see that you respect yourself, they're going to treat you with respect. It's levels to a man becoming the prize. And a man can think he's the prize. Other people can see him as a prize, but if he doesn't believe it, or he hasn't accomplished those goals that he wrote down, he might not feel like he's surprised. He might not be focused on relationships.
Hmm.
So, yeah. It's a lot of different things. Just like me, I believe a woman can be deprived once she does a lot of different things. Domestically, mentally, physically, like weight loss, eating health. It's just so many different things. But what do you consider men? Like, when does he become the prize?
When the man has various options, when the man is financially in a place where he doesn't need to get anything from a woman, when the man is don't necessarily have to go into work and work for someone else because there's a possibility that he could be laid off from work, mm-hmm. and that's going to change the whole paradigm of that life. When he's realizing that he has a I don't give a fuck attitude. If she wants to be with me, be with me. If not, get out of here. You got to have that kind of attitude. A man can never, a real alpha male can never be attached to something that he can't walk away from. Because if he gets something that he can't walk away from, then that's power over him, not him powering over that. The Most High created a patriarch, which made men in charge. And so the divine order that the Most High created in this earth was Adam, and he made him his vicegerent. He created Adam to rule while he's not here on earth. Then he created a woman to help Adam to rule, not to be his equal, but to be a helpmeet, to help him accomplish the things, which is why Adam named everything, not the woman. It was Adam that named all of the animals and so on and so forth. That duty was placed upon Adam, and he gave him a helpmeet. And as soon as he gave him that helpmeet, a little while later, because she wasn't placed in the position that Adam was placed in, she betrayed the Most High, Yahweh, and her man, her husband, and made a covenant with the devil. And see, that spirit is still always on women. And so I understand that. And if the man doesn't keep that woman under some form of godliness, she's going to cheat just like the man. And this is why the woman has degenerated in such a low level that she believed she could go out and have sex with multiple men because a man is created like that. But she can't. The man is external. Her organ is internal. So what goes in her is being deposited into her, right? It's not true with a man. So anytime a woman actually have intercourse with a man, she has to submit. So when a woman submits to multiple men, not necessarily at one time, but in a sequence of events, it messes her up mentally. And this is why so many women are discombobulated, because when a man penetrates a woman, he's putting spirits in her. So she has all of these different spirits in her from different men going up in her and leaving their DNA. And so she's taking on a little, all of those personalities, which is why she's thinking the way that she thinks. But in the true nature that the Most High created her, she wasn't like that. She wasn't meant to be that way. It's this world that's convinced her that if he could do it, you could do it too. You ever wonder why? Men that has been with a lot of women, women won't admit it, but they're more attracted to those kind of men because they know that he could always attract someone else. Women, the more men that she's been with, the less attracted every man will be to that woman. The more men that she's been with, her value becomes lower and lower. It's not the truth. It's not true for men. It's just the way that things are. You said it's not fair, but it's the way that it is. If a man or a woman has been out with a lot of different men, he get laughed to scorn. He get clowned. Mm-hmm. I said, yo, man, what's up with that, man? Y'all had her. I used to do that. My man used to hit that. And then I'm like, damn, you cuffed her. It's like you get clowned. It's like you geeking. Mm-hmm. You really married her, son. You know what I mean? But if the man's been out there, a woman is saying, nah, I don't like that, but she's intrigued by it. She's really intrigued by it. Because she knows she has a man that a lot of different women want. And that makes him more valuable. And women will come on here and lie about that. But it's true. They're pretending.
Well, that's my perspective. I don't I don't believe a woman wants a man that has slept with a lot of women. To me, that is a sign of like lacking discipline. It's like, what did that one woman that you were talking to, what did she have that you were trying to search for in other women?
What was that?
That's funny. It's like, why isn't a man satisfied with one woman? Why is he what is he searching
because
for?
Because it is not women? In his nature. Remember the initial question that I asked you? Why can a man go out and you still yet to answer it? Why can a man go out and impregnate seven women in the same night? So as long as he can ejaculate and all of them's fertile, he could impregnate all seven women and have seven different children by seven different women 9.5 months from now. Why can't you do that?
Yeah, that's
what
having sex. That's what it is.
No. Tap dancing around the question. Pregnant. You're tap dancing around the question. Why does he have that capacity though? Why did God give him that capacity? Why does a man have that ability and you don't?
Because when a man has sex and he ejaculates, that's going to be the result to it. He's going to get someone
telling
pregnant.
Me why he has that ability.
Why though?
Why? Why though? Why does he have that capacity?
I believe
that's... Why did the Most High give that to the man and the Most High didn't give that ability to the woman?
Yeah, that's fine that he didn't give it to the woman.
But we're asking
like
why,
just because
though?
It doesn't mean he should do it.
Okay, so then why does that's he have it, sis? Why does he
just
have
because
it?
A man has it doesn't mean
so the Most
he should
High
go out and improve.
Okay, okay.
It doesn't mean he
should. Answer that. She, okay. She getting her hair is over. Right
okay, okay. Okay, come
you
on.
You can't say most women not getting pregnant. Why would what's the purpose of getting them all pregnant?
You know why? You know why she would not get pregnant? Because she has a problem. Either she has fibroids or she has some sort of fertility problem. Mm. Right? Or she's just not to the point where she's ovulating. But if he has sex with her and she's ovulating and she's fertile, she's going to get pregnant.
God.
So again, you have not answered the question, why did God give him that capacity? Why does he have that? And you see, you're trying to play God when you try to deprive a man of that.
Just because he has that capacity, a man can't, you can walk down the street and kill somebody. Just because you have the capacity of hold up a gun
that's not the same. Okay, so
we talking about procreate. We ain't talking about
we're not talking about destruction. We're not talking about
so
that.
You're saying that God gave the ability to do that just to reproduce constantly every single day?
If that's his choice. Let me ask you this.
So that's what he did specifically.
Let me ask you something. I'm gonna ask you again. Do you believe in Yahuwah, the Most High?
I believe in Jesus Christ, yes.
Okay, well, that's a whole different subject right there. We don't believe in that. That's a comic book thing. Jesus Christ, who exactly was he? Where did he come from? Where did that name come from?
You
realize that the letter J is not an original letter, right? You realize the letter J came from the letter I, right? And the letter I was pronounced with the Y, right? With the Y sound, right? So the J was that like 1500s? 1600s. That's when they came into creation. They decided to put a tail on the letter I. So the I, when you read the King James translation, is pronounced with the Y sound because they brought that over from Latin. So the correct pronunciation would have been the Y there. So the J come from because they worshiped the Greek god Zeus. So when you're saying Jesus, you're really paying homage to Jesus, which is Zeus, which was a Greek god. But you understand that the Greeks got their letters from Hebrew, right? It's the same letters. The Alpha came from Aleph. The Beta came from Ba, a Bet, and so on and so forth. So all of the Greek letters are nothing but stolen Hebrew letters. So the Latin, we know that came later. So So the English is a transliteration of Hebrew, Greek, and Latin. And so the J came much later. So Jesus wouldn't exist when Yahusha or Yahweh Shai walked the earth 2,000 years ago. There was no such thing as a letter J. There was no such thing. So he could have never been called by that. So everyone that gets on their knees and pray to Jesus is not praying to anyone, because he doesn't, he was never called that name when he was walking on the face of the earth, right? That's something that's modernized that they threw on our people. Now, when you trace back the lineage to this man that you're calling Jesus, his real name is Cesare Borgia. He was the second son of the sixth Pope of Rome. His father's name was Rodrigo Borgia. The one that you're calling Jesus had sex with his sister, Latricia Borgia. He had her husband killed, and he had sex with his sister. So that was the first incestuous